It's incredible. This antenna opens up the world of very low frequency radio. Today we are sharing instructions how to build the clever loop. You can receive VLF signals with a PC sound card, a dedicated receiver, or a powerful SDR receiver, just like I'm doing right now. Looking at these results, a friend said, "Hey, what the hell is this? There are so many mysterious signals in the 3 to 30 kHz range that I didn't know about before. They include time signals, weather effects, navigation, control, communication signals, etc. The loops we have built so far are covering shortwave and longwave. But this one is literally opening up the world of very low frequency signals. By the way, if you're interested, feel free to check out our antenna playlist on Electronics Unmasked. Our earlier investigations were showing that single-turn loops are really powerful, together with a well-dimensioned transformer. It's a clever alternative to large VLF coils, and now we are showing how to build it. Electronics is fun, and with professional quality printed circuit boards, your projects will be perfect. It's super easy. Just check out PCBWay, the sponsor of this video. Upload your Gerber files, select the type and color of the printed circuit boards, and place your order. Production is completed within 24 hours, and depending on your shipping option, the finished parts will be on your table in no time. Take the easy way with PCBWay. You can simply pin them anywhere. The shape isn't important. According to our dimensioning, a 6.28 meters circumference corresponding to a 2 meter diameter is well suited for the LF and VLF ranges. You can use any cable as long as its loss is significantly lower than the loop's impedance. We explained it in a previous video. Its working principle is relying on its low impedance, allowing us to transform the signal voltage up. We disassembled 13mm chokes using its ferrite cores to build two RF transformers. The split core balloon solution was great for experimenting, by the way. For the DIY proposal, however, we decided to glue the ferrite cores together and install the transformers in a junction box along with switches. Wrapping the ferrite core with paper is reducing parasitic capacitance between windings. About 100 turns of 0.3 mm copper wire fit on the core. The primary winding consists of 3 turns of 1 mm cable. Sorry, I made a mistake in the last video. Many thanks to sophisticated viewers who pointed it out to me right away. The voltage transformation ratio T is 100 divided by 3 equals 33. So far I was correct. However, the impedance transformation ratio is 33 squared, equals 1089. I better call it TZ now. 24 turns of 0.5 mm insulated wire fit on the ferrite core, resulting in a ratio of 8 or 64 respectively. The size of the loop, the transformation ratio, and the frequency range are related as follows. With a ratio of 1089, we are transforming the receiver's 50 ohm to 0.05 ohms, pulling maximum current from the loop in the VLF range. With ratio 64, we are reaching the lower LF range. If you want to receive lower frequencies, use a larger loop. For higher frequencies, use a smaller one. With a smaller transformation ratio, you're getting an impedance matching at higher frequencies. Its circuit is straightforward. A switchable ground connection to the center of the primary winding can suppress interference. A double switch allows changing between LF and VLF mode. A second switch is connecting or disconnecting ground. Why are we using two balloons? And couldn't this be done with a single one that has tabs? We will see in a minute how parasitic capacitance affects the frequency response in practice. In the end, it turns out that two are better. With the new results, I will improve our simulation model so that this can be calculated. That's certainly worth a separate video. The entire assembly and installation into that junction box took about 3 hours. This antenna is delivering superb signal levels, even though I'm using it indoors. Reception of my DCF77 reference signal has improved by another 10 dB compared to the last tests. When switching from the conventional loop to the new one in LF mode, low frequency signals are increasing. Switching to VLF mode, the reception levels at the very low end are increasing further. Some signals sound quite bizarre, some even a bit creepy. At first I thought it was just noise down here, but in reality it's a lot of narrowband radio signals. Folks, there is a lot to discover for radio enthusiasts. Have fun with this antenna. By the way, very long wave radio signals are almost not affected by the time of day or weather. Some are reaching worldwide, and they are received usually from exactly the transmitter's direction. When rotating the antenna, please note the following. Standard world maps are misleading when it comes to the incidence angle of radio signals. For example, it appears as if North America, viewed from Germany, is exactly westward, and Australia is southeastward. Unfortunately, this is completely wrong, as we will see in a minute. You need a so-called azimuth map, also called beam map, with your location in the center. The azimuth angle is defined north over east. Setting up my loop antenna like this, its radiation lobes are pointing east and west. For North America, I have to rotate to 315 degrees instead of 270. In other words, I have to point northwest instead of west. Reception of Australian stations would be not good at all, with a radiation lobe pointing southeast or 135 degrees. You have to rotate to 75 degrees, which is close to northeast. There's a link below to a great website that lets you generate an azimuth map for your location. We are always very happy receiving comments under our videos. We'd like to give a big shout out for all your interesting questions and your experience shared. And I'm recommending it to everyone. It's really worth reading the comments under our videos. The single-turn loop is delivering strong signals thanks to its large antenna area. For optimal function, a suitable impedance matching is crucial. And I find it useful that you can easily exchange the loop size or simply experiment with two or three turns. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.